Good morning students, I am Pawan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 7th standard students. I have given you some introduction part of the chapter, that's motion and time chapter, that is 4th chapter. Students, I have already given you a definition of motion and definition of rest. I have sent to you the definition in text form in our WhatsApp group, students. I hope you are learning that. Okay, and let me give you explanation, clear cut explanation about what is motion again. Students, what is motion? Motion. In science context, in science perception, motion means it's a process of movement. It's a process of what? Movement. Process of movement. See students, when do you say an object or anything or any vehicle or something is in motion? When do you say that's in motion? If you take a vehicle, what is this? Car. The car is in this particular point. Okay, the position of the car is here. If the car's position is changed after some time, okay, after few seconds or minutes or hours, that means with respect to time. Okay students, if the moment of the vehicle, if the position of the vehicle changes from one place to another after some time, after few seconds, the position of the car, this is position A. After few seconds, the position of the car is changed. Okay. See students, after few seconds, the position of the car is changed. The position came to point B. So then you can say the vehicle is in motion. Got the point? Understand? And here the direction also you can consider here. You have to take the direction of the moment also into account. Now you can say the definition. An object or any vehicle is said to be when it changes its position from one place to another. Okay, an object is said to be in motion when it changes its position from one place to another with respect to what? Its surroundings in a given time. Okay students, when an object is said to be in motion, here I will write the definition. Here I will write the definition. An object is said to be in motion when it changes its position with respect to its surroundings in a given time. Okay, students, I already gave you this definition in text format in our WhatsApp group. Students, you please try to understand. Okay, an object is said to be in motion when it changes its position with respect to its surroundings in a given time. Yes, its surroundings you take, there may be a tree, there may be mountains, there may be buildings, okay, there may be buildings, apartments, houses, and there it's on road. No, road is also its surroundings. Road doesn't move, right? Buildings doesn't move. The mountains doesn't, mountain also doesn't move. The tree also doesn't move, right? Okay, the surroundings doesn't, the surroundings, they don't move. The surroundings of the object, they don't move, but the object, you just take it, car is an object here. The car is changing its position from one place, A, position A, one point, one place to another, place B, okay, with respect to its surroundings in a given time. Time you take, that may be in seconds, minutes, hours, or days, or whatever it is, time. Okay, students, like this you have to understand how motion is defined, okay, how an object possesses motion. Students, like this you can understand. And then another word that I gave you in our WhatsApp group, students, that is rest. What is rest? See, quite opposite. This object is in motion, but the surroundings are not in motion. You have to change the definition. An object is said to be not in motion here when it doesn't change its position with respect to its surroundings in a given time. It is the definition of rest. Okay, it's the definition of rest. Two definitions are important here. You try to remember, students. Two definitions are important. One is motion and another one is rest. So like this you can understand what is motion and rest, students. Okay, and next we have some activities and we have some other concepts of the chapter that we will see in the next video, students. You just remember these definitions and this question. The questions may be asked on these two words in your assessment, formative assessment 2 in the coming tests. You please remember that. And this is for today, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.